guys, it's Elena, and I've had a request from some people in my Facebook group who want to know how to make a stamp that they can use to sign their pieces when they have finished with them so that they don't have to write out their name every time. And I have this stamp that I've been using, and so I'll walk you through how I made it today. And I've also made a template that will be available in my free resource library for my subscribers. The link to subscribe is down below, and just send me a message if you're not sure how to get to that library because it is new. But anyway, so I'm going to show you how I made this, but first I'll just go ahead and show you how to use it. So I have this stamp, it says my name on it, and I've used it down here. You can see that I've got it in gold right down here. So I'll show you how I did that. So I just make a new layer over top of this piece that I've already made. And I have black selected, but you can select whatever color goes with the piece that you are working with. And then I've got my stamp selected. And when you just stamp on there, you can see my name appears. But I'm just going to make it a bit smaller. That's a bit too small. So something about like that. And you can see it doesn't really show up on this piece. So I could also use white. Oops. Like this. So in this case, I am going to go ahead and use the black because I wanted to make it gold, kind of like this one that I had showed you before. And I just want to show you real quick how I did that. It's not necessary, but I just wanted to show you some of the fun things that you can do with this signature stamp. So on the layer where I've added my signature, I will tap it and make it an alpha lock. And I'm going to select a gold color. And I'm going to go to my gold rush brushes and select a foil brush, and then I'm not on my gold. There it is. Okay. And then I will just make that gold. So you can do some fun things with stamps that way. Anyway, I'll go ahead and show you how I did this and how you can do it too. So you can start a new document, which is 2048 by 2048 pixels, and this is the standard size for making brushes in Procreate, actually, for the grain or the stamp. So go ahead and select that with a white background, and then use black. And to write your name, you can use any brush and write it out. So like if I wanted to use my lettering brushes and just write my name out, I could do something like that. If you are not really into lettering, you can also use a font to write your script out. And that's actually what I have done on this stamp template that I've made. So in order to add a font on this screen, all you have to do is go to the gear icon and then make sure you're on the add action, add text. And this font is a font called Modena Script by Jen Wagner. And I really like it. You can use any font that you have in your system. I'm going to go ahead and write my name out. And I'm just going to make the square go all the way out to the edges. Almost to the edges. And then I'm going to highlight all my text and make it go quite large. Okay. And then I'm going to go to my arrow. And I'm just going to center it. Actually, I'm just going to zoom out a bit and then go to my arrow and center it on this page so that it's right in the middle. So going to snapping, I'm going to turn on magnetics and snapping and distance and velocity all the way up. And this way you can center your text right in the middle. Whenever you see this orange, yellowish orange line, then you'll know that it's centered. So now it's centered in the middle. And I'm just going to move it over. So you saw right here, it's hard to get to it. There we go. You can see when the orange and yellow is on both sides, then it's completely centered. So, okay. So this is your stamp that you're going to be using. And in order to make this into the stamp brush using the template, first you're going to want to copy the canvas, which is a nice new feature in Procreate 5X. So go up to the gear icon, and then hit copy canvas. And that's all you have to do. Now the whole thing is copied. So now go back to this stamp template and duplicate it. And then when you go to the shape, press edit, import, and paste. And then the stamp that we've made pops up. And I think that I've already inverted this, but if for some reason you see that it's white in the background and black on the writing, which is what it looks like when with what we just made, just tap it with two fingers and that inverts it. So you want it to be black with a white writing instead of white with a black writing. Okay, and so we've made our stamp template, and I'm just gonna go ahead and go over the rest of the settings here just to, for anyone who has not downloaded the template. So the stroke path, spacing is all the way up, everything else all the way down. Taper does not matter at all. Shape, this is where we have our shape, and everything else is just not turned on at all. Just leave all that like it is. Grain is just the regular blank. You can get a blank background by going to edit, import, source library, and then it's just the one that says blank. Okay, and rendering doesn't really matter either, but I have it at light glaze. The only thing that matters on this page is that the flow is all the way up. That's very important, otherwise it won't come out completely solid. This doesn't matter, this is just the standard, and the same with all of these. And that's it. And then if you want to change your, put your own information in here, you can do that. And then create new reset point so that you won't lose the stamp if you accidentally reset your brush or something like that. Okay, that's basically all you have to do to make a signature stamp. And I hope that this was useful to you. Let me know if you have any questions.